What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Rayweather back here, and in today's video, I'm going to be going over the 5 biggest things that need to be fixed in Madden 20. Now, before I get into that, let me say that these aren't necessarily things that I think need to be fixed. There's a couple on this list that I do agree should be fixed and tuned a little bit, but this is mostly what I'm seeing the community talk about, the things that the community is saying is either broken or it's too overpowered or things of that nature. So I want to kind of give my take on these things because I keep seeing them come up day in and day out, and most of y'all here that know me know I'm pretty much against most patches and updates to the game. I like to just let the game play out unless it's something that's completely game-breaking. I don't think there's anything in the game right now that's completely game-breaking. I think that Madden 20 in its state right now is the best Madden I've played in years, especially gameplay-wise. It's not without its issues, but it's so much better to me. And I've seen other people agree with this. A lot of people agree with this. It's so much better than what we've been playing. So I'm in favor of just don't touch anything and leave it alone. But the community's talking, so I want to give my opinion on these things. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, hit that bell icon if you want to stay up to date on the latest Madden tips and news. Let's get into it. Number one on the list, without a doubt, the armbar superstar ability. This for sure is the most overpowered thing in the game right now. And this is one of the few things that I think definitely could use a little tuning. And EA has actually come out and said that they're going to address this because they know it's a little too overpowered, and they're just kind of saying, like, hang tight in a couple days or, you know, a few days when that update rolls out. It's going to be a lot better. And basically the thing with the armbar right now is there's only 4 running backs in the game that can do it, right? But when you got guys like Zeke, for example, and with how good, you know, he is as a running back and how good that Cowboys O-line is, when you're running the ball with Zeke, I mean, he just feels unstoppable, because even when you hit him in the backfield, if you just spam the stiff arm button, because he has that armbar ability, I mean, he'll just throw guys off of him. And it doesn't happen every single time, but it is extremely consistent, and I've seen many clips of people just spamming the stiff arm button with the players that have the armbar ability, and I mean, they'll just literally throw a guy off, like choke slam him off of him, and then get to the next guy and just throw that guy off as well. And I've seen it happen 3 or 4 times in a play before, and my issue isn't so much with the armbar itself, but it's the ability that you could just spam the stiff arm button. I don't think it's ever good when you can just spam a button and get a desired result. Everything needs to be timing based, at least. You know, just like in years past where, you know, you could, like last year, you could just spam the strip button over and over and over. You didn't have to time it, and as soon as you got close enough to the guy, you would get him in the strip animation, and you had a good chance of stripping the ball loose. You didn't have to time it. You could just spam it. They fixed that this year. Same way in, like, older Madden, you could kind of get close to someone and just spam the tackle button over and over, and eventually when you got close enough, you would kind of get, like, a suction tackle reaction. I don't think anything like that is good for the game when you can spam a button over and over and get the desired result. Everything has to be timing. So I think what they're going to do is make it to where when you do pull off a successful armbar move, that your stamina is going to drain significantly, as it should. If you're throwing, you know, an NFL player off of you, it should drain your stamina and slow you down a lot. But you know, maybe they should make it to where you can't pull off the armbar behind the line of scrimmage. Like, you could still do a regular stiff arm, but in order for your armbar ability to activate, you have to be past the line of scrimmage, maybe. Because the biggest issue is, even when you're blowing up the run, sometimes people are able to spam the stiff arm and kind of throw you off of them, and they're able to get yards in a situation where you typically wouldn't see somebody get stiff armed when they're getting a run blown up in the backfield. So I do think that one can have a little bit of tuning, but overall, even if they left it how it is, I don't think it's completely game-breaking, because, you know, you can still stop the run in this game if you have good run defense. It's just annoying when they're able to spam that and still get easy yards the occasional times that it does happen. Number 2 on the list is probably the next thing I'm seeing complained about the most, and that is fumbles. There is a high rate of fumbles this year, and I mean, you could easily see 3 to 4 fumbles a game this year. And I've had a few games like that where I'm seeing 3 to 4 fumbles a game. But I've also had a lot of games where I've had no fumbles. And I will say that I think the fumbles are fine. This is something a lot of people don't like, but I've seen some other people talk about it, and I've talked about it with them. And I agree with the people that say that, you know, there's a skill gap to not fumbling in a sense. Like, sometimes fumbles, yes, they're just random, right? But this year, most of the fumbles are happening on big hits. If you're allowing yourself to take these huge hit sticks play after play, you should fumble a lot more often. I completely believe that, because you can avoid these big hits. You can go down and give yourself up, especially when you're going up against someone you know is a huge, like, he's going to lay that big hit. If you got Jamal Adams, you know, if he's got you in your crosshairs, or, you know, Luke Kuechly's got you in his crosshairs, you know, you should go down, Landon Collins. You know, you should think twice. Like, maybe I got my yards. Let me go down and live to see another play. But everybody wants to juke. Everybody wants to spin. Everybody wants to fake defenders out. And what happened is the last couple years has kind of gotten people okay with the fact that you could juke and you could spin right into hit sticks and you would hardly ever fumble. If you juke, if you time the juke wrong, or you're playing against a good player and he knows you want to juke inside and he lines himself up and you juke right into a hit stick, you should cough that ball up every time. You're juking right into a huge hit. Like, you're off balance, you're juking inside, and someone's squaring you up and laying you out. In past Madden, you could do that and hardly ever fumble, so people have gotten used to that, and now that they can't do that anymore, they don't like it. You know, you can cover the ball, and yes, sometimes when you cover the ball, you'll still fumble, but I guarantee you, if you cover the ball and brace yourself, you will fumble way less. Way less. It's not even close. It can still happen, but way less. You know, there's a lot of times where you could go out of bounds to avoid a hit, but people don't do that. They want to, like I said, they want to juke back to the inside. They want to get those extra yards, and sometimes you're juking right into that hit. You got to fumble that. Also, if you put your coaching adjustments, ball carrier on conservative, you'll fumble so much less, but nobody wants to do that because, again, they want to perform all the juke moves. So there has to be give and take. If you want to be able to fake people out at a high rate, you got to also be okay with being able to fumble at a high rate if you juke or spin into a hit. Like, that is balanced. That's fair. People want to just fake out the defenders with no risk of ever fumbling. But I promise you, if you put your ball carrier, especially late in games, put your ball carrier on conservative when you have the game like kind of locked up and you don't want to fumble, yes, you could still fumble sometimes on conservative. Like, there should be nothing in the game that prevents you from fumbling 100%. That's not realistic. But if you do put it on conservative, you will fumble so much less that it's not even funny. So there are so many ways around not fumbling. You know, first few games I played, I was fumbling 2 to 3 times a game because I was just eating hits every play. But now that I've started saying, you know what, let me avoid the hits, let me go on conservative when it's necessary, I'm hardly fumbling now. So you can avoid these things, and that's why I think it's fine. Number 3 on the list kind of goes hand in hand with the fumbling, and that is the hit sticks this year. The hit stick seems actually pretty easy this year, easier than it might have been in the last year or two. But I think the biggest issue with this that I've seen a lot of people complain about, and I agree, there's kind of two parts to this. So number one is the computer hit sticks. The computer hit sticks at a higher rate than ever before. There used to be a time where the computer would really never hit stick you. You had to manually do it, and I liked that. But now the computer will hit stick you if they have the big hitter trait, which, you know, probably close to half of the defenders in the game have the big hitter trait. Which means if you get near these guys, they're pretty much always going to try to lay you out and hit stick you. Now, I'm okay with the computer hit sticking because I don't think it's realistic to say, well, the computer should never be able to, like, you have a Jamal Adams out there. Just because you're not controlling him doesn't mean that he shouldn't be able to lay a big hit on you, because in real life, he's going to lay big hits. But I think the fumbling that happens from CPU hit sticks, that should be decreased significantly, just because a turnover in the game is such a big reward that I feel like a good amount of turnovers should have to be caused by the user. When the computer is able to just hit, and the computer is not going to miss a hit stick. The thing with the user is, at least there's some timing in it when you do a user hit stick. But the computer, if they line you up for a hit stick, they're literally never going to miss. Because the computer is pretty much perfect when it comes to things like that. So, if you just have a bunch of big hitters on your defense, and anytime you get near them, they're laying a big hit, and those fumbles are coming out, that's too much of a reward for something that you didn't have to do yourself. That's too much of a reward for something that the computer is doing for you. So I think I'm okay with the CPU actually hit sticking if they have the big hitter trait, but decrease the fumbles on that. Now, you can leave the fumbles the same for user hit sticking, because at least there's some skill to that. And then the second part of this with the hit sticks, I think, is that too many players are able to hit stick. Like, if you're the user, you could hit stick, you could throw an interception, and then you could hit stick the guy on the return with the quarterback and force fumbles. I've actually seen that happen a couple times this year. You could hit stick with the punter or the guy on the kickoff who's kicking the ball, whether it's the kicker or the punter. You could run down the field, hit stick with him, and cause a fumble. I think, and I've seen Problem actually say this on stream, and I agree, that I think your hit power should have to be a certain number for you to be able to perform a hit stick. And it doesn't even have to be high. It could be like 70, right? You know, but you got guys like QBs and kickers who have hit power that's like way below that, and they're able to hit stick and actually cause fumbles. So I think those are the things that need to be addressed. And these are things that those are tuning issues that won't break the game in a patch, because that's just slight tuning of like a very specific thing. You're not patching a play or like a complete different logic of the game that could break something else. So that, I think, could be adjusted. Number 4 on the list is tackling. I've seen people complain about tackling. I can't tackle. Tackling sucks this year. I think overall it is fine because you know why most people are having trouble tackling? It's just in the open field. Like I said, in past Madden, it's been a lot easier to tackle. You could spam the tackle button, get the suction tackle. You don't see that happen nearly as much now. And this is the thing. An open field tackle in the NFL is one of the hardest things to do. Especially, you know, all these running backs, whether they're juking you or whether they're just straight running you over, right? If you're a cornerback trying to tackle Zeke, he's probably going to run you over. He's going to throw you off of him, right? Or even, like, the receivers in the open field, guys like Odell, Tyreek Hill, you know, Stephon Diggs, whoever it may be. You know, these guys are good in the open field. These guys aren't easy to tackle, so they shouldn't be easy to tackle in Madden. If you have good stick on defense the majority of the time, you can wrap up and make a tackle. People just, again, they've gotten used to the past few years where it's just so easy to spam a button and get an easy tackle that now that it's not as easy as it used to be, they think it's broken. The only thing about tackling that I would say seems a little off is sometimes when you're trailing a guy and you're close to him, it seems like you can't tackle him like you used to. You can't get as many shoestring tackles, like trip him up. But, you know, all in all, it doesn't bother me that much because there was a lot of times where you would get shoestring tackles or get, like, suction tackles from the back and situations where you should have never been able to get it. So, yes, sometimes you're seeing less tackles that should be made when you're trailing, but you're also seeing a lot less of the unrealistic tackles from behind, too. So, with that balance there, I'm actually okay with it. But tackling really isn't that hard. It just actually takes a little bit more user skill to do it this year. And fifth, the last thing on this list are cloud flats. Cloud flats are definitely broken this year. This is something that I wouldn't mind being tuned, and this is why I said in a previous video that running cover 2 isn't really viable this year. If you're playing someone that kind of knows what they're doing, if you're playing someone that doesn't know better, yes, you could still run a cover 2, but if you're playing anyone that's even somewhat in the know, it's too easy to abuse cloud flats this year because they don't actually do anything particularly well. They let routes easily get over their head that they shouldn't, but then they don't really limit anything in the flats. Like, good cornerbacks in the past could still limit a flat route in a cloud flat, you know, limited to 3 to 4 yards on occasion because they had good reaction time, they could rally down to it. But now they're giving up 5 to 7 yards in the flat almost every play, no matter who it is. It could be Jalen Ramsey out there, it doesn't matter. But they're also letting routes that normally would never get over their head get over their head. So they're not defending anything good. They're pretty much a useless zone, you know, at least half of the time out there. And if it's a useless zone, then like, that's a problem. So I think that definitely could use some adjusting because it has kind of rendered cover 2 useless versus anybody that knows what they're doing. And I don't think that's a good thing to, especially in a game of Madden, you should never be limiting the type of coverages that someone could run. You can't just say, all right, it's just man or cover 3 this year. Like, no, you should be able to use cover 2 or cover 6, right? Because then it kind of makes things like cover 6 not able to be used as much either because half of the field in a cover 6 is a cover 2 shell, which has a cloud flat. So, I think they should look into maybe tuning that. But overall, these are the 5 things that I've seen talked about the most. Let me know what you think below needs to be fixed. And as always, I will see you guys next time.